Yes, good morning to all, and we are going to conclude the concepts, which is introduction to statistics first chapter. Before going to conclude the first chapter, we will discuss the previous concept what we have discussed in last class. Okay, ma'am. So conclusion. Before going to that, we will discuss what you mean by statistics. Hope you all going through with the concepts and the video what we are explaining. If you have a doubt, you can ask to sir. Because we can communicate. Okay, now we are again I am recollecting the concept what we have done in a previous class. Okay ma, statistics is, of course, it is the data. The father of statistics is Ronald A. Fisher. He is considered as a father of statistics because he has given the index number concept, which is also known as the index number helps for the, it is the very most significant concept in statistics. That's what that concept, because of that concept he has popularized, and he is known as father of statistics. And statistics can be explained in singular format and plural format. And singular format, already I have told you, it is the science of collecting, organizing, presenting, analyzing and systematic forecasting of data. Science of we will discuss in next class, with next chapter. Science of, which means that is a proper process or format, procedure to collect the data. The data can be collected in two sources. It can be a primary or secondary. In primary sources, we will collect the data directly from the people respondent. And secondary sources, what you do? You will gather the information from journals, papers, website and TV, media, etc., etc. So that we will discuss in later. So singular sense, it is the science of collecting the data. But in plural sense, we have discussed the numerical facts systematically collected. And data, what do you mean by data? That also we have discussed in last class. Data is the numerical facts systematically collected. Okay, you are coming here. I will ask you your marks. You will say, with the help of the 10th marks card, which is given by the SSLC board, the numerical facts systematically collected. The college is collecting the exact Xerox copy of the board, isn't it? Then they will verify the original. So systematically, proper systematically, accurate data can be collected. That is known as economic data. The data which are collected related to economic issues or problems. Yes, what are the economic problems we have discussed in last class? Economic problems are rising general price level, unemployment, poverty, price increasing, supply, demand, fluctuation, etc., etc. So that is the economic problem. When we collect the data related to economic issues, for example, the family income of the family or fluctuation, the standard of living of the people, if you want to collect, that is the economic data. That is what we have discussed in last class. And types of data. Yes, of course, we can classify the data into two types, qualitative and quantitative. Quantitative data, which means data can be expressed in terms of numbers, height, weight, temperature, etc. Qualitative data, the data expressed in terms of characters or qualities or attributes. Okay, height, weight, not height, weight, ma. Tall, short, good, bad, better, worst. Okay, east, west, north, south, male, female, etc. So, which we explain the qualities of a people. And statistics is not a suitable, sorry, substitute for a common sense in a daily life. That also we have discussed in the last class with the help of one story. A father and mother crossing the parents and the kids crossing the river. He used the statistical methods to cross the river without using the common sense and logical thinking. Then the two kids drowned in the river. We had a fun story about this. It could be a fun, but you should think logically. So even statisticians are saying, though you are expert in stat, you can't use all the time blindly. You need little caution and carefulness, or use the common sense or logical thinking to implement in your daily life. Okay, all the time I am keeping the average, mean, median, mode, x bar, algorithm or whatever it is, and I am implementing in my daily life. Mean, how will it be? The life will become a mechanized, isn't it? So sometimes we need to use our common sense and logical thing. All the time we cannot be a calculative person, isn't it? We are human beings. So this is all we have discussed in the last class. Now at last we are going to conclude our concepts, the uses or importance of statistics in economics. So what are the uses? Of course, I told you, without numerical help, You can't explain or you can't prove, you can't make understand anything. Even calculating national income, calculating your personal income, it can be a price of the product or whatever it is, ma. You need a data. Okay, even your marks. I told you in the first day class itself. If they say your child is passed in first PO, second PO, they don't accept. They'll ask you how much percentage they have scored. Why she or he scored less mark in this subject? Why they have scored more mark in that subject? We are planning to go for this. Our income is expectation is this much. Okay, so everything is numerical. So here it helps in. I'm going to explain that statistics helps only in economics point of view. You can compare with many subjects, which are the subject or which are the concepts, which are the daily use activities are there. Everywhere you can easy to understand. Yes, with this statistics you can prove everything easily. It helps in economic factors. Economic factors are land, labor, capital, organization, demand, supply. So then so many factors are there, ma. So this factor, how it is reacting when price of the product increasing, how the demand reduce. When the price of product fall, how the demand increases. The same way when price rises, what will happen with the supply? When price fall, what will happen with the supply? So this is how we can explain with the help of numerical values. When we prepare the table, price and demand. So you can easy to understand when the price increases to like this, the demand will fall like this. So there is an inverse relationship between price and quantity, demand for a commodity. Okay, so with the numeric, if I say in word, you couldn't understand. When I write it in format, see here price is increasing 2-4, increasing in rupees 2468, but demand is reducing from 10987, so reducing. So this is the thing. And consumption, yes, consumption, we are the consumer already. I have told you, being a human, everybody we will consume the product, but we will be consume on the basis of our income. We will calculate our family budget. So we'll be discussing in the second year budget line, budget set, everything is there, ma. So consumption, every people, you will, with the help of statistics, you will come, you can understand the people standard of living and consumption pattern across the world. Consumption pattern, middle income group, rich income group, and low level income group, and daily income earners, how they are spending, how they are planning to spend. So everything will come to know with the help of consumption concept, mathematical statistical methods, and economic problems. And previously we have discussed about economic data. Economic data is related to economic problem, which is known as economic data, isn't it? Raising price level, inflation, demand, supply, etc. So that is our economics problem. Then at last, economic plans and future. Yes, the economic policy holders, financial department, central level or state level or world level, the people, those who are higher authority to prepare the policy, macro level policy can be done with the help of mathematical tools only. Okay, even the time series analysis is a major concept in statistics, which helps to know the past and we can predict for the future. Cyclical trend, seasonal variation, secular trend, so many concepts are there, which is based on the diagram and the formulas. Okay, so these things will help for the policy holders to prepare the plan and compare with the past activities. Even I can tell you this, during this lockdown period, for example, if we take a stationery or a garage shop owner, what happened in the 3 months and what can be done in future, they will plan. Because anyway, though the shop is closed, they have to pay the rent and they have to pay the electricity bill. Okay, so they will plan. So the, for this plan, they need a statistical tools. At last, national income. Now it helps for calculating the national income. Statistics help for calculating national income. The national income measures, yes, GDP, GNP and the concepts of national income are gross domestic product, gross national product, which is also known as gross domestic income, national income, which means the total value of all final goods and services produced within the country is known as gross domestic product. Domestic, which means the within the geographical boundaries of a nation, within the country, and the products is produced and sold out, the value of the sold out product is known as GDP. Okay, and GNP, which means gross national product. This not only the total value of goods and services produced within the country, but also abroad, which means income derived from abroad. Our Indian people may work in foreign countries, they earn the income, they send to India. The same way, we people, we invest in foreign companies and we get the income. If we invest in foreign, we have bank sector, we earn the income. So everything will be included in the gross national product. So this and all we can understand, not only for this, for day-to-day life, for the family, as micro level, if you see the head of the family also, they need a statistical tool, which means my income is 20,000 or 30,000, within that only I have to plan for the daily life or monthly life. Okay, so hope you all understand about the statistics introduction. Thank you, children. Go through with the notes and the concepts. We will meet in next class. Thank you.